A very good morning, my dear students. I welcome you all once again for VTU eShikshana program. This is the second session on thermal radiation chapter of heat transfer subject for the sixth semester mechanical engineering choice based credit system. Myself, Dr. Madhukeshwarayan, professor of mechanical engineering, Jain Institute of Technology, Davanagere. You can note down my email ID and phone numbers which are on the screen, and for any doubts or clarification you can contact me on the given numbers. In the last class we have discussed regarding the concept of radiation, definition of radiation, and some of the examples of radiation. Also we have learned what is electromagnetic waves, electromagnetic wave spectrum, radiation properties of surfaces, and concept of different bodies such as black body, gray body, white body, opaque body, transparent body, and also we have learned the spectral emissive power, which is also known as monochromatic emissive power, and total emissive power. And along with that, we have also gone through the Stefan-Boltzmann equation, and we have learned Stefan-Boltzmann law and Stefan-Boltzmann constant. Today we'll continue with some more concepts of thermal radiation, and also we'll solve one problem on thermal radiation. This is the one of the example I have taken to know the concepts of total black body emissive power and total amount of radiation and spectral black body emissive power. The problem is like this. Consider a 20 centimeter diameter spherical ball at 800 Kelvin suspended in the air, as shown in the figure below. Assuming the ball closely approximates a black body, determine the total black body emissive power, total amount of radiation emitted by the ball in 5 minutes, and spectral black body emissive power at a wavelength of 3 micrometer. An isothermal sphere is suspended in the air. Now you can see this is the schematic representation of the problem, that is the spherical ball which has considered in this example, which is suspended in the air. This ball, spherical ball, is having 20 centimeter diameter and a surface temperature 800 Kelvin. We have to find out the total black body emissive power, total radiation emitted in 5 minutes, and spectral black body emissive power at 3 micrometer. And we have assumed that the ball behaves as a black body. Now coming to the first part of the example, that is we have to find the total black body emissive power. This can be found by using Stefan-Boltzmann law, and as per this law we have an equation: total body emissive power, that is E suffix B, is equal to Stefan-Boltzmann constant sigma multiplied by fourth power of absolute temperature. Therefore, substituting this value of sigma as 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 watt per meter square Kelvin to the power of 4. This value we have found in the previous session. temperature is given as 800 Kelvin, therefore multiplied by 800 Kelvin to the power of 4, which is equal to 23.2 into 10 to the power of 3 watt per meter square, or which is equal to 23.2 kilowatt per meter square. This means the ball emits 23.2 kilojoules of energy in the form of electromagnetic radiation per second per meter square surface area of the ball. The total amount of radiation, which is the second part, energy emitted from the entire ball in 5 minutes is determined by multiplying the black body emissive power obtained above by total surface area of the ball and also the given time interval. See, Q radiation is the total amount of energy radiated, which can be found by multiplying E suffix B, that is total emissive power, with the surface A suffix S area and time interval delta T. So AS, that is the surface area of the sphere or ball, is pi into D square, which is equal to pi into diameter 0.2 meter square, which is equal to 0.1257 meter square. Time interval delta T is 5 minutes into 60 seconds per minute, which is equal to 300 seconds. Now substituting the value of surface area and time interval delta T, we can find out total energy radiated. Therefore, Q suffix radiation is equal to 23.2 kilowatt per meter square total emissive power multiplied by 0.1257 meter square, that is surface area of the ball, into 300 seconds, that is time interval, multiplied by 1 kilojoule divided by 1000 watt seconds to convert it into kilojoules. Therefore, total heat radiated is equal to 876 kilojoules. This is the answer. The ball loses 876 kilojoules of its internal energy in the form of electromagnetic waves to the surroundings in 5 minutes, which is enough energy to raise the temperature of 1 kg of water by 50 degrees Celsius. Note that the surface temperature of the ball cannot remain constant at 800 Kelvin unless there is an equal amount of energy flow to the surface from surroundings or from interior regions of the ball through some mechanisms such as chemical or nuclear reactions. This indicates that the temperature 800 Kelvin, that is the surface temperature of the ball, cannot be constant unless an energy flow to the surface from the surroundings or from the interior regions by mechanisms such as chemical or nuclear reactions. Now, the spectral blackbody emissive power at wavelength 3 micrometer is determined from Planck's distribution law. as per this law, E suffix B lambda, that is spectral black body emissive power, is equal to C suffix 1 divided by lambda to the power of 5 multiplied by exponential C suffix 2 divided by lambda into T minus 1, where C1 is equal to first radiation constant 3.7415 into 10 to the power of 8 watt micrometer to the power of 4 divided by meter square, and C2 is equal to second radiation constant, which is equal to 1.4388 into 10 to the power of 4 micrometer Kelvin. Substituting these values, that is here C1 3.7415 into 10 to the power of 8 watt micrometer to the power of 4 divided by meter square divided by lambda to the power of 5, that is 3 micrometer to the power of 5 into exponential C2 1.4388 into 10 to the power of 4 micrometer Kelvin divided by lambda 3 micrometer into T 800 Kelvin minus 1. This is nothing but E suffix B lambda, that is spectral black body emissive power, is equal to 3848 watt per meter square micrometer, which is the answer for the spectral black body emissive power. The next one is Kirchhoff's law of radiation. This law was stated by Kirchhoff in 1860 year, which is one of the most important laws of radiation. This law states that the ratio of emissive power to absorptivity is constant for all substances which are in thermal equilibrium with the surrounding. This can be written in a mathematical form for three bodies as below, that is E1 by alpha 1, that is E1 is the emissive power, alpha 1 is the absorptivity of body 1, which is equal to E2 by alpha 2, similarly which is equal to E3 by alpha 3. E1, E2, E3 are emissive powers of body 1, 2, 3 respectively. Alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3 are the absorptivity of body 1, 2, 3 respectively. Assume a black body among these three bodies. Now I have assumed the third one as a black body. Therefore, E1 by alpha 1 is equal to E2 by alpha 2, which is equal to EB by alpha B. But alpha suffix B is equal to 1 for black body. Means absorptivity of the black body is full, that is 1 for black body, and therefore E1 by alpha 1 is equal to E2 by alpha 2 is equal to EB by 1. Now, rearranging the above equation, E1 by EB is equal to alpha 1 and E2 by EB is equal to alpha 2. But according to the emissivity definition, we can write E1 by EB which is equal to epsilon 1 and E2 by EB is equal to epsilon 2. Therefore, by comparing the above two equations, we can write epsilon 1 is equal to alpha 1 and epsilon 2 is equal to alpha 2. Or in the integral form, we can write epsilon is equal to alpha, that is emissivity of a surface is equal to absorptivity of the surface. Therefore, the Kirchhoff law states that the emissivity of a body is equal to its absorptivity when the body remains in thermal equilibrium with the surroundings. Next, we can discuss Planck's law of radiation. The total emissive power of a black body varies with wavelength at a given temperature and also varies with temperature. Therefore, it can be expressed as total emissive power E suffix B is a function of wavelength lambda and temperature T. In the year 1900, Max Planck developed the quantum theory of electromagnetic waves, and with the help of this, he has suggested the following formula for the monochromatic emissive power, that is E suffix B lambda of black body, which is based on his theoretical analysis, and it is given by the following equation. E suffix B lambda at a temperature T is equal to C suffix 1 divided by lambda to the power of 5 into exponential C suffix 2 divided by lambda T minus 1. This we will note it as equation A. In this equation, E suffix B lambda is monochromatic emissive power at absolute temperature of the surface T in watt per meter square meter. Lambda is wavelength in meter, micrometer. T is absolute temperature in Kelvin. C1 is first radiation constant 3.7415 into 10 to the power of 8 watt micrometer to the power of 4 divided by meter square. C2 is the second radiation constant 1.4388 into 10 to the power of 4 micrometer Kelvin. Here in Planck's law, the distribution for general temperature is shown in the figure 7. This is figure 7, which has a spectral black body emissive power at different temperature maximum. The distribution has maximum value at some wavelength. You can see at some wavelength for a particular temperature, it has a maximum value. The maximum value is found to occur at lower wavelength as temperature increases. Means T1 is greater than T2, is greater than T3, is greater than T4, which is greater than T5. So T1 being highest temperature, its wavelength is lower. T5 being lowest temperature, its wavelength at which the maximum value of the spectral emissive power takes place will be higher. The area below any one of curve gives the total emissive power at the corresponding temperature. You take any of the curve, the area below that represents the total emissive power at the corresponding temperature. The wavelength at which maximum value of spectral black body emissive power occurs at any given temperature can be found by differentiating the above equation A with respect to temperature T and equating it to zero. This gives the value of lambda max into T is equal to 2.898 into 10 to the power of minus 3 meter Kelvin. Now, this relationship is known also as Wien's displacement law. It is seen that maximum value of black body spectral emissive power decreases as T increases. So you can see, as the temperature decreases, the spectral emissive power also decreases. Substituting this value in the equation A, again we will get black body emissive power maximum multiplied by T is equal to 12.87 into 10 to the power of minus 6 T to the power of 5 watt per meter cube. It describes the spectral density of electromagnetic radiation emitted by a black body in thermal equilibrium at a given temperature T when there is no net flow of matter or energy between the body and its environment. This is known as Planck's law of radiation. Next one is Wien's displacement law. The monochromatic emissive power of a black body for a different temperature are plotted in the figure 6. This is the figure 6. You can see monochromatic emissive power versus wavelength, where x-axis represents wavelength lambda in micrometer and y-axis represents monochromatic emissive power E suffix B lambda. According to this, monochromatic emissive power of black body is given by Planck's law. This figure 6 shows that emissive power at a particular temperature is 0 at lambda is equal to 0. Now you can see at wavelength 0, emissive power is also 0. Then increases with increase in lambda. It increases for all the temperatures as wavelength increases and reaches maximum at certain lambda m. Now you can see for each different temperature the value of lambda m is different, and at that point monochromatic emissive power is maximum and then decreases and finally becomes 0 at lambda is equal to infinity. Now after this point all the curves comes down because the emissive power decreases as the wavelength increases and emissive power may become 0 at infinite wavelength, that is lambda is equal to infinity. Another important characteristic of this figure is the wavelength at which monochromatic emissive power is maximum shifts towards shorter wavelength with increasing temperature. Now you can see that as the temperature increases and maximum point of monochromatic emissive power for different temperature shift towards the shorter wavelengths. Now the maximum wavelength lambda max depends upon temperature T of the surface. The relationship between lambda max, that is maximum wavelength, and absolute temperature T at which black body spectral emissive power reaches a maximum value is called Wien's displacement law. It can be derived from Planck's distribution law by applying condition of maxima, that is differentiating black body emissive power with respect to lambda and setting it to 0. Therefore d epsilon b lambda divided by d lambda is equal to 0, that is d by d lambda multiplied by the value of black body emissive power, that is C1 divided by lambda to the power of 5 into e to the power of C2 divided by lambda t minus 1 and equating it to 0. After derivation and simplification, we get lambda max into t is equal to 2897.6 micrometer Kelvin. Alternatively, lambda max into t can be found at the peak of distribution curve given in figure 6, in which we also see that for a given value of lambda t, the ratio of black body emissive power EB lambda divided by t to the power of 5 is the same for all temperature. Substituting this value of lambda max t in the above equation, we get EB lambda max, that is black body emissive spectral emissive power maximum, is equal to C1 value 3.7415 into 10 to the power of 8 and divided by lambda to the power of 5 value 2897.6 divided by t to the power of 5 into exponential C2 1.4388 into 10 to the power of 4 divided by lambda t value 2897.6 minus 1. Now, which is equal to 12.87 into 10 to the power of minus 10 t to the power of 5 watt per meter square micrometer, which is also equal to 1.287 into 10 to the power of minus 5 watt per meter square per meter wavelength. So another form of Wien's law is therefore E suffix B lambda max divided by t to the power of 5 is equal to 1.285 into 10 to the power of minus 5 watt per meter square Kelvin to the power of 5. Now we have an interesting example here by which we can learn Wien's law in a better manner. The example is like this. If you are in a northern hemisphere and look up at the sky on a clear evening, you can see the constellation Orion. Constellation is nothing but a group of stars which makes a pattern of a particular figure. Here the figure is nothing but the hunter as shown below. One star in this constellation, Rigel, flickers in a blue color, and another star, Betelgeuse, has a reddish color as shown in the figure. Now you can see this one star in a blue color is here and another in a reddish is here. Which of these two stars is cooler, Betelgeuse or Rigel? Figure is the Orion constellation. The red star Betelgeuse appears as Hunter's right shoulder. Now this star is nothing but Hunter's right shoulder. The giant blue star on the bottom right side, Rigel, which appears as Hunter's left foot. Now this is the bright blue star which appears as a Hunter's left foot. Now we will apply a strategy to solve this problem. So we treat each star as a black body. Then according to Wien's law, its temperature is inversely proportional to the wavelength of its peak intensity. The wavelength lambda maximum for blue, that is for blue light, is shorter than the wavelength lambda max that is for red color or red light. Even if we don't know the precise wavelengths, we can still set up a proportion. So now you can see lambda max red into T red is equal to 2897.6 micrometer Kelvin, and lambda max blue into T blue is also equal to 2897.6 micrometer Kelvin. When simplified, the above equation gives, or rearranging the above equation gives, T red is equal to lambda blue maximum into T blue divided by lambda red maximum. This product or this quantity is less than the blue light temperature. Therefore, Betelgeuse is cooler than Rigel. Now you can see that the blue color is having the lesser temperature. Therefore, Betelgeuse is cooler than blue color is having greater temperature. Therefore, Betelgeuse is cooler than Rigel. The significance of Wien's displacement law. Wien's displacement law tells us that the higher the temperature of an emitting body, shorter is the wavelength of the radiation it emits. The qualitative analysis presented in this example is generally valid for any emitting body, whether it is a big object such as a star or small object such as a glowing filament in an incandescent light bulb. Means, so this example what we have discussed, it shows that the size of an object doesn't matter, whether it is a big body such as a star or small body such as an incandescent bulb. Wien's displacement law, that is temperature of an emitting body, shorter is the wavelength of the radiation it emits. So this is applicable. So our next topic is a gray body and emissive power of a gray body. So we have already discussed in the previous class what is a gray body. Now, if the surface of the solid body absorbs a definite percentage of incident radiation waves, irrespective of their wavelength, then the body is known as gray body. Its absorption lies always between 0 and 1. Means the absorptivity alpha value is in between 0 and 1. When the absorption of a body varies with wavelength of radiation waves, the body is known as colored body. So if this absorption of the body varies with the wavelength of the radiation waves, then that gray body is also known as colored body. In general, the body, whether it may be a gray body or color body, so the wavelength will be in the range of 0 to 1. The emissive power of a gray body is always less than that of a black body. In the same proportion at all wavelengths at a given temperature as shown in the figure 8. So figure 8 is in the next slide, I'll show you. Means here the emissive power of a gray body grey body emissive power is less compared to the black body emissive power at all the temperatures. This further states that ratio of emissive power of grey body to that of black body at a given temperature is constant for all wavelength. Now you can see the figure 8, which has the emissive power of black body shown by this above continuous thick black line, and gray body, so this line continuous smooth curve below the first one, that is this represents the emissive power of the black body, and real surface, this scattered curve, thin line, represents the emissive power of a real surface. The total emissive power of a gray body is always less than the total emissive power of a black body. Now you can see that this is the total emissive power of a black body or total emissive power of a gray body. So this curve, gray body curve, is less or below the black body emissive power curve. Therefore, always black body emissive power is higher compared to the gray body emissive power. At the same temperature, means T is constant, for both we have taken temperature constant. And this behavior of gray body is taken into account by a factor known as emissivity. Now, this behavior is considered or taken into account by a factor that is known as emissivity. Then emissivity of a gray body is defined as below. See here, the x-axis represents the wavelength and y-axis represents the total emissive power. Now, how to define emissivity? Emissivity is nothing but it is a ratio of emissive power of a gray body at temperature T degree Celsius divided by emissive power of a black body at temperature T degree Celsius. Now, we know that always a black body has a greater emissive power and a gray body emissive power is in the range of 0 to 1. And this ratio of emissive power of a gray body to that of emissive power of a black body at a temperature T degree Celsius represents the emissivity. Emissivity is denoted by the Greek symbol epsilon, which is equal to E suffix G divided by E suffix B. Therefore, epsilon is equal to EG by EB. This is the emissive power of a gray body, and this is the emissive power of a black body, and this is the definition of the emissivity. With this, I will conclude today's session, and we have learnt some more laws in this class. For any doubts or clarifications, you can contact me for my numbers or you can drop a mail to my mail ID. We will continue with some more problems, solved examples and laws of radiation in the next session. Thank you very much.